Hey, welcome back, Mechanical Pros. Got Tyler with me, and we're going to talk about hot taps. Tyler, why do you do a hot tap?
There's a lot of times that we have situations out there that we need to tap into a line that either one can't be isolated, can't be drained.
Installing a water source heat pump, or you know, a smaller line set, chill water, hot water to a piece of equipment. So I'm thinking water source heat pump and cool units. Smaller chill water coils and such. So tell me how you go about doing a hot tap. I'm sure there's a right way and a wrong way to do it.
Well, first off, you find your common header that you want to tap into.
Okay.
You get the size of it and what kind of threadlet you're going to use. And
okay, so this is a threadlet. Mm-hmm. What we're putting on here.
Yep.
Okay.
And so the first thing you're going to do is just find your location that's going to go.
Okay.
And you're going to make a weld.
It looks just like a coupling.
Yep. Pretty much. Yeah. It's just saddled so it fits on the pipe to make a good weld.
Okay.
You weld that first. Make sure you protect your threads. Don't get any slag BBs in there that would create a leak, because once you drill this, you know, there's no going back.
No going back.
You're in the live side. So you want to take all precautions to protect all your threads.
Okay.
So at that point, you know, we've got this hot tap set up that has a valve here that you can drain your pressure once you're tapped into the line.
So, okay. So you could run a hose of that and run outside if you needed to or whatever.
And not create a mess if you're in that environment, you know.
Okay. And tell me what we got. What are we doing with this valve here?
So this valve will be the isolation valve that stays in the system.
Okay.
So here we've got a shaft that has in this particular one, a half inch hose saw bit. So what we would do is we go ahead and open this isolation valve.
Okay.
And obviously there's no hole in the pipe yet.
Okay.
And then we're going to take and we're just going to run. We're going to run, once we've penetrated the pipe, the hose saw has now penetrated the pipe. So now you will back this out. The pressure will push the piece back with the hose saw. So once you...
So the piece of pipe wall that we just cut out, the pressure is going to push it back out.
The pressure will, and also the brand that is specifically used for hot taps, it's magnetized, so it holds that piece in the hose saw. So once we're backed out past, now we're all live to here. So what we're going to do, we're going to shut our isolation valve, making sure that we're back in here, and then we would just release our pressure here. And at that point, you would take your hot tap off, and now you have your supply or return, whichever one this is.
Already with an isolation valve ready to go.
Yep. Yep. And we didn't lose any water or what little was here. No downtime.
Yeah.
No chemical loss or whatever the case may be.
Yeah. Very cool. So, but the wall of the pipe that we're drilling out, how often does that go downstream or into something else?
It won't. If you use a magnetized hose saw,
okay,
it will stay in, and then you would push back out. And what you will do, in most cases, good practice, you take your piece, you zip tie it here to prove.
Okay.
If something happens downstream to another one, you have yours to verify that you left yours here.
And then hang it. I see it hung over the isolation valve, so everyone knows that wall of pipe is not somewhere down the line in a piece of gear messing up your flow or something else. But we're proving that it's right here. We took it out.
Yep.
And that magnet and the pressure helps us get it out.
Yep. Because in cases there might be other contractors in doing the same thing that don't do it. So in the case that a piece of equipment goes down, hey, here's the one we did. We tagged it MRG. That's our proof.
All right. Very cool. Well, thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right. So hit that like, hit the subscribe. If you got anything to add or you got a question, hit down in the comments. And we'll check you back out on Mechanical Pros. Thanks for tuning in.